The Islamic fasting month of Ramadan set to begin on Tuesday, March 12th. This after moon sighting committees across the country reported no sighting of the moon. The President Marcos on Sunday expressed his solidarity with the Muslims preparing for Ramadan, which he said has a special significance in the country. Marcos added, "The occasion is a time of reflection and spiritual growth, which he hopes could strengthen kinship among Filipinos." Despite his message, the government has yet to declare the start of the Muslim Holy Month as a holiday. This led to the disappointment of from some Filipino Muslims in the country.
Kailangan na holiday kasi siyempre lahat kami nagtatrabaho, nagbi-business. Kailangan bigyan ng oras itong pag-start namin ng Ramadan.
Ramadan is the ninth month in the Islamic calendar. Marked as a period of fasting and prayer, Muslims refrain from eating and drinking from sunrise to sunset. Agriculture Secretary Francisco Chiu Laurel Jr. orders an audit on rice stocks of the National Food Authority. This following the illegal sale of rice stocks to commercial traders. The ombudsman has ordered the preventive suspension of 139 officials, including the NFA administrator, 26 branch managers, and 12 regional managers over the sale. Chiu Laurel says they will be scrutinizing all data and information starting in 2019, when the rice tariffication law was passed. The secretary wants to determine if there is a pattern to the agency's disadvantaged sale of rice stock buffer. Now, the Philippine Navy welcomes more than 100 new reservists in Batanes Province as the country ramps up its military presence in the northernmost parts of the Philippines. A total of 119 Batanes locals, called the Ivatan people, attended the graduation rites after completing their basic citizen military training. The Philippine Navy Chief Vice Admiral Toribio Adasi Jr. says the recruits will serve as an additional mobilization force during national security situations, as well as in humanitarian and disaster response, among others.
Ang Batanes Group of Islands ang itinuturing na last and northernmost frontier ng ating bansa. At malaking bahagi pa nito ang kailangan nating tuklasin. Kaya naman dapat lalo nating pag-usayin ang ating kakayahan at paigtingin ang proteksyon laban sa mga nais sumakop nito.
Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro Jr. on Friday said the Department of National Defense and Armed Forces of the Philippines have adopted the comprehensive archipelagic defense concept to protect the Philippines' exclusive economic zone and ensure that the country would benefit from the natural resources in its territory. Part of this is to ensure an increase of military presence in Batanes. More countries seem to hold military exercises with Manila. The Philippine Armed Forces says France is slated to join this year's joint military drills between the Philippines and the U.S. It adds Japan and Australia also have commitments towards the Balikatan exercises. The AFP, meanwhile, clarifies the upcoming drills are not meant to provoke any country, including China.
Karapatan po kasi natin, no, ng bawat bansa na i-enhance yung ating mga depensa. So, ito pong mga exercises na to is to enhance our defense posture and looking at like-minded nations on how we would be reacting on certain instances. So, hindi lang naman yan, sir, sa pakikibaka, pero pati rin po sa ating mga HADR operations, no? Yung mga pag may sakuna, mga ganun po. Wala po yung any tension to irk any other issue. Nagpe-prepare lang po tayo for any eventuality.
The Balikatan exercises will begin in the third week of April in the provinces of Batanes and Palawan. Authorities have yet to disclose the number of troops participating in this year's military drills. But last year's iteration of Balikatan was the largest ever, with 17,000 soldiers participating. Filipino gymnast Carlos Yulo snags a bronze medal in the men's floor exercise at the 2024 FIG Artistic Gymnastics World Cup Series in Baku, Azerbaijan. Yulo finished behind rivals from Belarus and Japan. He, however, failed to defend his titles in the vault and parallel bars, where he won gold last year. Despite the setback, Yulo has already qualified for the 2024 Paris Olympics, along with fellow gymnast Alea Finnegan. They will be joined by pole vaulter E.J. Obiena and boxer Yumir Marshall. Veteran actress Jacqueline Jose laid to rest Sunday. Jose's family kept the details of her interment private as they appeal for respect during their time of grieving. Throughout the week, her colleagues and friends paid tribute to Jose, noting that she left a lasting legacy in the industry. Jose passed away on the morning of March 2nd due to a heart attack. President Marcos recognizing the adulthood of his firstborn, Sandro Marcos. The Ilocos Norte 1st District representative turned 30 last March 7th. In the president's latest vlog, he and his wife greeted their son by giving him books. But the president chose a more mature one, gifting the younger Marcos a sex-related book written by a foreign stand-up comic. First Lady Liza Marcos, on the other hand, chose a Taylor Swift-related book entitled Be More Taylor. While the first couple cracked up at their choice of gifts for their lawmaker's son, they also dished out serious advice for the young Marcos.
30 years old, di ka napapagod. Hindi totoo yan. Listen to your body. Don't burn the candle at both ends too much. Eat well, exercise, try to have a routine. It's the usual thing. But you will start to notice some differences in your body. I remember when I turned 30, when I was in my 20s, yung bilbil ko, dalawang tatlo araw lang na kaya ko tanggalin. Pagtawid ko ng 30, not so quick. So, you know, you have to make adjustments.